Cool. Are you kind of ready? Sorry, I just gave the thumbs up to Fitz.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know.
Could you do lights get this up so they know what I'm doing?
Yeah.
I
The blue dial.
No. Number one. Number four.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome once again, and good evening, good afternoon to you all again at this time. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back from the burn. Now, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, Mr. Professor, nice to make a great stand for my ladies and gentlemen. Elliot Parker right here. Now, we are venturing into the realm of Samantha music demonstration. We are venturing into the realm of science for music, ladies and gentlemen. Please, without further ado, Elliot Parker. Thank you. Hey.
This is going to be my assistant Fitz for this evening. Today I want to raise your awareness of sound, and to do this we're going to explore the different ways that sound can affect our consciousness. You see, we have a special relationship where sound and music can dramatically alter our emotions. Now I ask you, why is that? How does sound actually work, and is it possible for us to see sound? We know that sound is vibration, and as sound vibrates it pushes the surrounding air in all directions away from the source. Now we're able to hear sound because these waves are reflected off the surfaces around us, straight into our ears. Now, throughout the year I've studied the different effects of sound. An example of this is when we're exposed to different sounds and environments, our brains emit different waves, which are divided into four categories. The first being alpha. Now these are emitted when we're in a state of physical or mental relaxation. The next are the beta waves, and I can imagine that my head is probably throwing these out at the moment, because these are emitted when we're in a state of alertness or agitated. Next we move on to delta. Now these are emitted during deep sleep. And the final are theta, which are when we're in a state of reduced consciousness, for example when we're meditating. Now I want to start by explaining that most of the sound around us is accidental. Because of this, our relationship with sound is often having to speak over the background sounds around us, suppressing the information we don't want to hear. Now, this subconscious activity can again be broken down into four categories, and we can start to see a relationship between sound and our emotions. The first, physiological. Sorry about that. Any of you that might have jumped, even though it wasn't as loud. That's your brain releasing the cortisol, a natural instinct for fight or flight. The next, in contrast to this, we have the sound of waves. In contrast to this, we have the sound of waves, which have a relative speed of around 12 cycles per minute. This has been associated with the speed of human breathing. And through my studies, I've found that by surrounding yourself by naturally beautiful sounds such as this, or my next example, we have found that when the birds are singing, it's safe to go outside. So over time, naturally, our bodies and our ears have evolved to pick up and suppress certain sounds. My next category is psychological. In my first example, if I were to play this for a little bit longer, you would all hopefully start to feel a little bit thoughtful, you know, and reflect on things. In contrast to that, we have this, which I'm sure you'll all agree makes you feel a little bit warm inside. Moving on from that. Sorry guys, bear with me 2 seconds.
No, it's at the beginning.
So while my Mac decides to do something, in contrast to that, I did have Vivaldi's Four Seasons, which to me ultimately does sound a lot happier than the Welsh National Anthem. But I think we'll all agree that anyone that's dealt with the job centre will know that that isn't a happy song. So, my final point for the psychological effects of sound. Many of you will be familiar with this. Now, we all know there's actually the sound in the film that created the suspense rather than the big robotic fish we used to create the film. So, moving on to my next category, which is cognitive. This is the way our brains process sound, how we deal with suppressing all of that information around us. For example, now, if any of you can actually tell me what that just said, fair play. Answers on a piece of paper later. But no, so basically, our brains are developed where we can't distinguish two separate conversations at the same time. I found during my research that the only way close that we can do this is by having two, rather than two conversations, having something to sound to you. If two people were to sing to you, your brain can actually somehow deal with those two songs going on. Now, my last example for cognitive, not sure if any of you are aware of this, but within MRI rooms and surgeries around the country, around the world, they're using something called isochronic alpha waves. Now, these are used to help induce brain activity amongst intensive care patients, and they sound something like this. They're played rather quiet in the background, and they can help to influence sort of brain activity within intensive care patients. If you're trying to study, sounds such as these can be helpful to improve your productivity. So moving on from the productivity, moving on to my final category, we have behavior. Now you wouldn't expect someone driving along to this to be driving at a steady 30 miles an hour. If you can go back to what I was saying about productivity, you'll also find that surrounding yourself with sounds such as these, your productivity is proven to drop by around 33%. So if you recall what I said earlier about the natural sounds, if we can surround ourselves with sounds such as these, your productivity is proven to go back up by around 33%. Now, my final point for the way that music can affect our behaviour is the way that brands are using sounds more and more increasingly in their adverts, their marketing. And so how many of you can instantly distinguish what this is? Or the ever more famous? And hopefully you're all thinking, I'm loving it. We'll see. So, moving on from this, I want to talk to you about somatics. Somatics derives from the Greek word kuma, meaning wave, and the study shows sound and vibration creating physical effects on matter. There have been studies conducted in the past by physicists such as Hans Jenny and Ernst Chladni, who were pioneers in this field. Now, I've been experimenting throughout the year, and what I have here today are two experiments that I've built. The first experiment is known as a Chladni plate, which is this on my right. It's been constructed as a small 10-watt guitar amplifier, because any good DIY project starts at home. Goes from there. So literally, we got the guitar cab. Inside, I've got a 6x9 speaker. For those of you that can see, we've got a center rod that goes down into the center of the speaker cone. It's been supported with a little bit of blue tack, because again, DIY, it's great. And you've got this top plate. Now, when I say that, basically, the purpose of this experiment is to show the effect of standing waves across different surfaces. In this case, my top plate surface.
Sorry
guys, just bear with me. Right. Now hopefully, this will go as well as it has all day today. You'll see that as I start to play frequencies in and adjust the volume up, that we'll get a small amount of reaction on the top plate. If I move up through the notes, hopefully,
on the amp.
Sorry. find the right frequencies, we can start to see some complex images appear on the plate. I'll sweep through the frequencies now to see if I can find a couple more. And you'll see that as I reach the higher frequencies, the figure becomes more complex. It's a bit too high by the seams of it. Mr. Assistant, can I have some more salt, please? Just on the way. Salt. Salt. That's the one. That's the one. Now, as I said, the point of this experiment is to find standing waves. Now, standing waves don't occur on every single frequency. So you'll notice that as I sweep through, some frequencies are having more of an effect than another. Most of the things, but we'll move on from this. So if you could.